Welcome to Wonderland Weekly, hosted by Toronto Tie. Now sit back and have a wonderful week.
Hey everyone, Toronto Tie back here at Canada's Wonderland once again for the second and final week of Oktoberfest. Going to check out all the new haunt prep that's been going on, get on quite a few rides. I'm here with my family today, so we'll see how much actual activity I end up filming. And just super excited for another awesome day here at the park. Super excited because the park has built a Halloween store here. So they've got these witches out front for this awesome photo op here with you standing in the cauldron, I guess. absolutely love that. This is just fantastic. I am super, super, super excited to show off everything that is inside the haunt store. Honestly, all this makes me think is, why didn't the park do this sooner? This is amazing. I love all these, all these little haunt or Halloween decorations that they have for sale. This is amazing. I love it. This should have been a thing from long ago. This is brilliant. So many Halloween props. I love this. Absolutely. Love this. So many decorations. Honestly, I love this. I love this. And another awesome, awesome, awesome photo op here with this creepy thing coming out from the depths. Love it. This is so fantastic. I love it. Haunted carriage with all sorts of awesome, awesome, awesome things available for purchase, and repurposing this, which they used for Winterfest. And yeah, I think Winterfest really inspired them to, let's do seasonal stores. And please, yes, 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 absolutely love this. Awesome, awesome, awesome displays here. I love this. This is fantastic. This is just, this should have been done a long, long time ago, but I'm just glad that the park has done it. I wonder if there are any other seasons that might deserve their own stores, their own themed shops here at Canada's Wonderland. I mean, I can't think of any off the top of my head, but let me know in the comments, what sort of seasonal store do you want to see in the future? And, of course, Squishmallows. There had to be Squishmallows, right? You got the jack-o'-lantern, you got the skeleton, you got the black cat, the witch here, and a ghost, of course. Absolutely love this. This is all fantastic. You've got haunt mugs here. You've got haunt hats there. This is perfect. I love this. Everything about this. You've got haunt sweaters. You've got haunt shirts. You've got these little guys. I forget what they're called, but you've got them. And yeah, another haunt shirt. Ooh, I actually really like this haunt shirt. I might have to get that. We've got a Dead on Arrival skeleton sweater. Yeah, more haunt mugs here. Yeah, absolutely love this. This is fantastic. Oh, you've got a really, really nice embroidered haunt sweater, varsity jacket. I think that's what you call it, with the leather arms. And yeah, that is super, super fancy. Love that. And skeleton or skull shirt. And another even creepier skull shirt. This is fantastic. I mean, it's I love every single bit of this. Awesome, awesome, awesome little stuffed critters here. I don't think they're technically Beanie Babies, but I think they're by the same company. And yeah, just any Halloween decorations that you need, come here for them, because the park definitely has something for you. This is fantastic. I love it. I don't know how much is for purchase, like this stuff that's on display. I don't know, but if it is, awesome. If it isn't, it still makes for a great decor for this awesome Halloween shop. This is, yeah, fantastic. Over here on the marketplace, or sorry, Oktoberfest house patio, once again, I got a refill on my stein. Had a little bit of trouble getting it through front gate, but once I told them that I bought it in the park, they were like, oh, okay, yeah, that's fine. And got me the chicken schnitzel. So looking forward to having this. I love this. This is fantastic. Week 2 of Oktoberfest is in the books here. Oktoberfest house is amazing. I love the idea of putting all the Oktoberfest foods in there into marketplace. The live entertainment here is it's pretty interesting. And obviously there is the lack of a live band, which does take away from the event a little bit. But outside of that, I honestly think this is one of the best Oktoberfest events that the park has held so far. Yes, I did get a refill on my stein from last week, and it's just been a fantastic day. And this is fantastic. I love Oktoberfest, and I hope that it's... I don't understand why it's not at more parks. I mean, honestly, it's such a great event. Please, other parks, introduce it. It is fantastic. Merry Halloween, everyone. The park is currently, while they are preparing for Halloween Haunt, they are also preparing for Winterfest over here at Jester's Courtyard. Always fun to see the park doing so many different projects at once. And I'm excited to see this shop open. I wonder if it's going to open early like it did in 2019 last time. Then I thought, maybe they're just really trying to encourage people to, come check out Winterfest. This year, I don't know. I mean, I guess it's never too early to start your holiday shopping, right? I absolutely love watching Yukon Striker from all the way here in Planet Snoopy. Hello there! How's it going, Franklin? Awesome. You're having a great day? It's always a great day at Canada's Wonderland, right? Awesome. It's that time again. Blue ice cream. Matches my shoes. Over over here in Medieval Fair, we have Skeleton Crew returning after a multi-year absence. Not sure exactly how long it's been, but basically ever since Devil Circus arrived at the park, then it kind of replaced Skeleton Crew. So really, really interesting to see this return, as well as Inferno, the new show at the park this year. Love, love, love the temporary lighting structures that they have here. They could have just done a very, very, very basic concrete base and, you know, whatever, just like black posts, but no, these really fit. I love the added details here, and yeah, super excited to see Skeleton Crew back here at the park once again, and of course that target right there means Sink the Jerk is back. I love Sink the Jerk. He is yeah, absolutely great. it's such a fantastic little game show thing that really basically only Wonderland can do. So yeah, love to see that is coming back. Obviously that target will not stay here, but oh, this is fantastic. I'm so looking forward to Haunt next week. Speaking of Sink the Jerk, they have this awesome sign here which says, please excuse our appearance as we prepare for Halloween Haunt. And yeah, out in Arthur's Bay, they have packed up most of the trampolines. Not quite all of them. Still got a little bit of work to do, which is why they have the sign. And they have the structure here with the seat at the top of this tower for Sink the Jerk. Oh, I am so looking forward to seeing that jerk just plummet right into the water here at Arthur's Bay. Over here by King and Trader and Chuck Wagon, this is really interesting. They have closed off the entire pathway from here to Mess Hall. So the area that is normally the pathway leading to Splashworks. Yeah, just really, really interesting to see a section of the park closed off like this. Obviously it is as they prepare for Halloween Haunt. And yeah, you can take a quick peek here behind the fence and see that, yeah, they're preparing a scare zone. I believe it is Frontier's Revenge. It looks great. This looks like an outdoor maze, honestly. And I love it. I don't know if it's gonna be open during the day, you know, for the rest of the season, or if this is going to be standard, that they're going to keep this closed during the day and just open up this pathway during Haunt. I don't know, but I like this. I think that this is, if this is a sign of what the other scare zones at the park are going to look like this year, then ooh, I am super, super excited. Last week I had noted the extra lights, the string lights that had been hung between Top Glow and Alpenfest Amusements over here. And now the park has gone ahead and added some carnival flags as well. This is great. I absolutely love this. Definitely seems like Carnival is going to be larger than usual, and yeah, I am all for that. Larger scare zones, yeah, more immersive ones. I am all for it. This is fantastic. I only have one thing to say. Can we maybe keep string lights and flags here all year round? It really kind of fits in Alpenfest. I love seeing this spider display. It is one of my absolute favorite haunt displays that the park does every year. Possibly my absolute favorite. It's I love it. It's so perfect, and you know, again, something that basically only Wonderland can do, because what other park has a coaster drop like this? This is fantastic. I absolutely love it. This is wonderful. Love to see this every year.
I love the jack-o'-lanterns hanging from around here by the entrance to World Expo. And of course, as soon as my blog entry on the flags of World Expo gets posted, then the flags of World Expo end up being taken down for the season. So, of course. Yes, but if you have not checked out that blog entry, I'm going to try not to ramble as much as I did last week. Yes, I will have a link to it in the description. Yes, this is part two of a two-part series. Super, super, super excited about that being posted again. I feel so honored to be featured on the park's website, and I had a lot of fun writing it up, looking into the history of World Expo and all the different all the different countries which had pavilions essentially here in World Expo when the park first opened in 1981. So yes, please go check that out. And thank you to everyone who has shown their support for it. Again, it was a lot of fun to write. A lot of research involved with the first part, not so much the second part, although a little bit. And again, thank you to the park, everyone at the park who got that to happen. That was, it's a dream come true, and I absolutely love it. Also, here at Backlot Cafe, this is unrelated, then we have some skeletons hanging out here. Always, always, always love seeing the skeletons. Over here by Chicken Shack, they have set up the Devil Circus stage. Now, it's not going to be Devil Circus this year, and I hope not too many of the standard Devil Circus acts are missing, but this year it is going to be Inferno, which, you know, sounds like it's going to involve a lot of fire, so that's really, really cool. Super excited to check it out, see how the show differs from in years past. By Yukon Striker's first drop and second drop for that matter. I'm able to look over here and see that there is some haunt prep going on. So yeah, really, really cool to see these set pieces in place. Again, I believe this is for Frontier's Revenge. I really hope I'm not messing up that name. I really, really appreciate this. I like it. This is looking great. I don't know why this isn't where Frontier's Revenge was last time. I love that they moved Frontier's Revenge down this pathway just a little bit, making excellent use of this future expansion plot. That's what I'm going to call this section of grass here. Future expansion plot. But yeah, I love the graveyard that they have set up here and all the other props. I am really, really excited to see how this scare zone is now that they have relocated it and I believe expanded it. Again, it does, from Yukon Striker, appear to be more maze-like than I think I was, than I think most people were expecting. But yeah, I'm excited for it. I have high hopes. Last week I mentioned that Whitewater Canyon is closed for the season, which is true. But since then, the park has put up this sign, and this is a custom-made sign. It says. Whitewater Canyon is closed for the season. Please excuse our appearance as we prepare for a future experience. That's really, really cryptic. I know there are some theories out there about a possible, something similar to Forbidden Frontier at Cedar Point. I don't know. This is really, really strange to me because I mean, the park didn't need to have a Cryptic sign up. They could have just said Whitewater Canyon is closed for the season. This is kind of boggling my mind here. I don't know what is going on here. I am shocked. This is really, really strange. Are we going to see actual work being done in the next few months or something? I mean, I don't know. Again, this is really, 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 really throwing me off. This sign here. Such a great guy. I didn't get to spend too much time with him today, but his content is awesome. If you haven't checked it out, please, please, please go over there. And this was a fantastic day. Looking forward to Haunt starting next weekend. I won't be able to get here on Friday, unfortunately, for opening day, but I'll be here on Saturday to check out everything that is new this year at Halloween Haunt, which is going to be a lot of things, it seems. And just overall, super, super, super excited about Camp Spooky Haunt. Yes, I do apologize for not being able to get here for the ACE event that happened yesterday. I just was not able to for various reasons, but I do plan on coming to all the ones in the future, so look forward to that. And until next time, as always, have a good one!
Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to like the video, comment with anything you'd like me to cover in the future, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and support me on Patreon so that I can visit more parks and create more wonderful videos.